did God call me to religious life? What did God call Peter, John the Baptist? And how the call of God can be heard by any human being?
So that we need to take time for solitude and prayer, and that's why John and Andrew listened to John the Baptist in the desert and took time to adore, to contemplate, to read the Word of God. And then one day, Jesus came to them and called them.
I was called from my mother's womb to be a priest and a religious, like Samuel, Amos, Ezekiel, Isaiah, and so many others. God gives His grace only to the one He calls.
I remember when I was a student in California, practicing all kinds of sports, it was hard to hear the call of God, though I knew somehow in my heart that He was calling me to maybe be a missionary, a priest, or I didn't know exactly. I was doing at that time a lot of hang gliding, skiing, tennis, and all kinds of sports, even tap dancing. And when you do too many things and don't spend enough time in prayer, it's harder to listen to that tiny little voice, the whisper of God in your soul.
Isn't it striking that the first time Jesus opened His lips in the Gospel is to ask the question to the two disciples who are beginning to follow Jesus after John the Baptist said, "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world." As soon as they heard, they just followed Jesus. When Matthew was receiving the money from people, Jesus passed by and said, "Come, follow me." And Matthew obeyed immediately. What is that mysterious calling of God? How you who may be searching for your vocation, how to hear the call of God? Ultimately, we all have the same vocation, to be happy in heaven with God after we die, that's for sure. But on earth, we can be married, religious, celibate, but giving our life to others and having a personal relationship with God. That's what we want. The cows here cannot have a special relation with God. And Mrs. Cows, what do you think?
It's very important when we are discerning a vocation to marriage or to religious life or to the priesthood. So let us have the attitude of Samuel, as we see in the first reading today, who was called by God three times during the night. And he answered, "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening." So let's do the same, and the Lord will enlighten our path and show us what to do. Really, I'm convinced that no one can be happy on earth, truly happy, unless he or she is actively seeking what God wants from them. Because our beatitude, our happiness, is to be with God forever and to do His will. God bless you all.